Injuries to the central nervous system are devastating, and unlike many other tissues, central nervous system doesn't heal or heals extremely slow, but instead the damage spreads and more neurons are dying, even though that have not been injured by initial injury. What we know about injured CNS is that there is a lot of immune response in the site. These cells have been considered to be detrimental, but now we know through works of many labs and ours that this immune response to CNS injury is actually a beneficial response. But how does the injured CNS, injured brain, injured spinal cord, decide what type of cell to bring and how to activate that cell in a way that is beneficial and not destructive? What we showed here is that the injured CNS sends a damage-associated molecular patterns which activate T-cells not through MHC-TCR interaction, but rather through mediated signaling, which induces cells to produce interleukin-4, which we now show is a critical molecule for the benefit that T-cells mediate on injured CNS. This IL-4 then downstream activates injured neurons through IL-4 receptors on neurons and potentiates neurotrophin signaling. So I think our finding may bring to light a new therapeutic approaches for CNS injury.
In our recent study, we examined the role of antigen specificity in CD4 positive T cells after CNS injury. It's long been known that antigen-specific CD4 positive T cells are especially beneficial after CNS injury, but none of these studies addressed whether they're actually this antigen specificity is actually necessary for the recovery from injury that you get from CD4 positive T cells. To address this question, we used MAT2 knockout mice, which aren't able to either develop or activate CD4 positive T cells. To these mice, we transferred either CD4 positive T cells or a thymus from a wild type mouse. This allowed these MAT2 knockout mice to have CD4 positive T cells, which can't be activated in the periphery. Much to our surprise, we found that in these mice, even though they weren't able to activate their cells in the periphery, we still had a beneficial response from having the CD4 positive T cells. To see what these CD4 positive T cells might actually be producing that gives them their beneficial effect after injury, we looked at the cytokines they expressed both in the site of the injury and in the draining lymph node, and found that IL-4 particularly was increased after injury, whereas the pro-inflammatory cytokine interferon gamma was not increased. To see if this IL-4 might actually be what these cells are producing that leads to their neuroprotective effect after injury, we looked at mice that had IL-4 knocked out, or at RAG mice that received either wild-type or IL-4 knockout CD4 positive T cells. What we found is that in the mice that lacked the IL-4 in the CD4 positive T cells, there's a worse neuronal survival than in mice that had IL-4 production from CD4 positive T cells. So in fact, this IL-4 is playing a neuroprotective role after CNS injury. So if we have T cells that are being activated in a antigen non-specific manner to produce IL-4, we postulated that possibly this signal that's causing them to produce IL-4 might be coming from pattern recognition receptors instead of from antigen-specific interactions. To examine this, we looked at mice that lack mediate, which is a signaling molecule that's important in pattern recognition signaling. And we found that in mice that are lacking mediate, there's a deficit in both IL-4 production by CD4 positive T cells after injury and in neuronal survival, thus implicating pattern recognition receptor signaling and IL-4 as major players in CD4 positive T cell response to CNS injury.
Just heard from Jonathan Kipnis, it is known for a long time that T cells can be found after a lesion, be it a traumatic or other lesion in the central nervous system, at the site of the lesion itself. We could show that these T cells found there produce interleukin-4 and are thus rather T cells with a regulatory role skewed towards the so-called T helper 2 T cell phenotype. Then thereafter, we were able to show that T cells producing interleukin 4, the so-called T helper cells, but not, for example, T helper 1 cells, which have more a pro-inflammatory role, were able to induce axon growth when these T cells were transferred into the site of spinal cord injury. Interleukin 4 receptor is indeed expressed on neurons and also on corticospinal tract neurons. And thereafter, we dissected the mechanism further in cortical explant cultures, which are a very good in vivo mimic of axonal outgrowth after a lesion. We found that interleukin 4 producing Th2 cells increased, in fact, axonal outgrowth. And since interleukin 4 acts through an ACT and MAP kinase signaling pathway shared with neurotrophins, we then demonstrated that neurotrophin 3 potentiated the observed effect of outgrowth via interleukin 4. Why are those observations now so relevant? Neuroprotection and repair is so far not really possible in trauma, in neurodegeneration, and also in inflammatory damage of the neuronal compartment, like in multiple sclerosis. While we have therapies for the relapsing remitting disease phase of multiple sclerosis, the rather inflammatory disease phase, we have no effective drugs for the progressive phase of multiple sclerosis. And our observations indicate that exactly in this phase, we might have a therapeutic potential of interleukin 4 locally as repair strategy in the central nervous system.